Hello, this is Adolf. Welcome to the video lecture series on the course of design of steel structure. And this is the lecture number 6 in the unit number 6, that is beams. In this video, we are going to see about the built-up beams and what is the design procedure for the built-up beams. Let's go to the topic. Built-up beams. So, this built-up beams consist of rolled steel section such as I-beams connected with plates at their flanges. So see in the diagram, it is an I-section. So and the flange, we have a plate that is connected to it. So it is a built-up beams, two sections that are connected to form, to act as a one section, that is called a built-up beams. So when this beam will be used is, the depth of the beam is fixed, and for that the same depth, the section modulus of any available joist is insufficient. So we will go for a build-up beams. So that is, you fix the depth of the beam, and for the available depth, for the fixing the depth, you don't have the section modulus. The available beams doesn't have a section modulus. Then we will go for this build-up beams. Second one is, the span of the beam is large. The length of the beam will be large. And the loading on it is also heavy. That will be a heavy loading, and the length of the beam is also large. So, none of the available beam sections satisfy the required section modulus. Then we will go for the build-up beams. So, first, the depth will be fixed, that is, if the depth of the beam is fixed as an 100 mm, so for that particular depth, the section modulus is not available, then we will go for the build-up section. Second, the length is very large and the loading is also very heavy. The heavy amount of loading is acting on the beam. So what will happen? Heavy loading, the section modulus required will be high. So the modulus of section will be very high. So, for that particular section modulus in the market, we don't have the the available section doesn't have meet the required section modulus, then we will go for the build-up beams. And what is the design procedure of build-up beams? So, given the span of the beam and the loading, proceed a build-up section in the following steps. So first they will give the span of the beam and the loading. Then we will go for the, what is the procedure to find the design procedure to find, design procedures to design a build-up beam. First, we have to calculate the maximum bending moment and maximum shear force. Maximum bending moment and maximum shear force in the beam we have to calculate first. Second, we have to find out the permissible bending stresses. So what is the permissible bending stresses we have to find? So this is the permissible stresses that are given. The first one is, it is a compound girder composed of rolled I-beams or channel with cover plates of thickness. This is the forms. One is I-section, one is a channel sections. So the thickness or the diameter is up to and including 20 mm, that is 0 to 20 mm. The yield stress will be 250 mm, and the maximum bending stress is 165 newton per mm square. And if it is greater than 20 mm and including 40 mm, your yield stress is 240 newton per mm square, and your permissible bending stress is 158.4 newton per mm square. And if it is greater than 40 mm, then your yield stress is 230 newton per mm square, and your permissible bending stress is 151.8 newton per mm square. So these are the permissible bending stresses. After the permissible bending stresses, we have to calculate the required section modulus. So how we can calculate the section modulus? Z is equal to maximum bending moment by bending stress. So where sigma bc mbt is equal to permissible bending stresses. So after we finding the section modulus, then we have to find out the approximate area of each cover plate. So what is the, if it is assuming, if you are having an I section with a plate, so we have to cover plate area, we have to find out. So that is the approximate cover plate area, AP. So how we can find the approximate cover plate area is Z suffix R minus ZA by H. So ZR is, we know, required section modulus, that is M by sigma BC. ZA is available section modulus. What are the available section modulus that are available? So suppose if you are choosing some member and that is having a section modulus of 1500, okay, into 10 to the power 3 mm3. So your section required is 1450 into 10 to the power 3 mm power 3. So this will be the area of the approximate is equal to ZR minus ZA. So that is 50 into 10 to the power 3 divided by height. So height, H is the depth of the beam section. What is the beam's depth? So from that we can find the approximate area of cover plate. So after finding the approx area of cover plate, we have to find the gross area of flange plate. So how we are going to find the gross area of the flange plate is, we have to take as 30% of extra. So 30% extra of area of the cover plate. So if it is area of the cover plate is 100, means your AG will be 130. So 30% extra we have to consider. So why we have to consider that 30% means to account for the rivet holes, because by using the rivets only we have to connect this cover plate and the flange of the section. So we have to consider that 30% for the rivet holes. And then after the gross area, we have to check for the outstand of plate. So outstand of plate is, so assume you are taking a I section and here you are taking plate and you are connecting with the rivet over here. Okay, assume you are connecting with the rivet over here. Okay, so what is the outstand means? It is the distance from free edge to the first row of rivet or weld. So that means here it is you are connecting one rivet, another one here, another one here. Okay, so outstand is the distance between the free end to the first row of rivet. So same as here. So these are the outstand. So how this outstand, it should not exceed 16 mm if it is in compression flange, and if it is in tension flange, it should not exceed 20 t. So t is the thickness of the plate. So after that, so for a riveted buildup beams, so if a beam is a riveted buildup beams, the actual bending stresses are calculated as follows. So if you are using a riveted buildup beams, riveted, you use a rivet to connect the two sections. So that is a riveted buildup beams, and the actual bending stresses are calculated as follows. So calculated bending compressive stress is same. Sigma BC is equal to M by Z. This is same. For the calculated bending tensile stress, sigma bt calculated is equal to sigma bz into ag by an. So ag is gross area of the flange, but and an is net area of the flange. So sigma bt is bc into ag by an, that is m by z into ag by an. So this is the difference. So in this video we covered only the build up section and what is the design procedure of the build up sections. So in the upcoming videos we will do the problems that are related to the build up sections. Thank you.